Good morning. We are live. Today is Saturday, August 27, 2016. Welcome, Jim. Welcome, David. Welcome, Angie, Brian, another Ready? Angie in Jim's room, Bree, John Nally, Megan, Michelle, and Sean. And we have 25 seats in this room, so there is tons of people can join even more, right? Right. So the announcements are for today. Tomorrow I'm making a special free webinar. Jim will join. Jim, are you joining, right?
Yes, at 11 o'clock tomorrow, Eastern Standard Time.
Yep. It's going to be on emergency preparedness. Emergency preparedness is a special keyword for, you know, if something happens like economic crisis or volcano eruption or something of that sort of disaster, you know, keeping their flashlight and water and toilet paper stocked. And what do you do next? And I will make it happier because I have a message, a happy message. And the happy message is about ascension and the change and what do you do with it. And how do you deal with the change, and how do you deal with the disasters, and what is your place there, and how you become an avatar, and Jesus, and Krishna, and a galactic ambassador altogether. So that's the main topic. And it's going to be for 4 hours, from 11 to whatever it is, 11 plus 4, more like 3, right, to 3 p.m. Eastern time. The classes are coming. We rescheduled the Reiki classes, next Reiki class, sign up for Reiki 1A, and it is September 18th now, and you sign up on humancolony.org. We did tons of work to make this site more functional because it was very slow. Now it's the response time is 2.5 seconds, which is reasonable compared to other sites. 2.5 seconds, it's you click, you get your page. And there is unified Hucolo calendar on every page, and the events are there. And our friends in Hucolo, we are proud to have helped other people to become channelers and create their own channels. So if you wish, if you wish to be on this calendar and you wish to be part of the Hucolo community, that's, you know, that's an open invitation. Get together and coordinate here. So we have now three major places where we publish our events. It is humancolony.org, Hucolo on Facebook, and Hucolo TV on Google Plus. And we intentionally make it distributed. It's not one place. It's not one leadership. It is a community with multiple sources. So if the site goes down, there are other backup places. So that's intention. We are not centralized. We are decentralizing intention. So also we have open volunteer positions for managing, hosting, administrating the webinars, this Saturday webinar and other webinars, and also we have openings for channelers, guest channelers, and other kind of, how do you call it, stars. So there is administrator and a star on the webinar. Today we have Jim starring, so other days the star positions are available. So join us and star here.
Okay.
I think that's about it. There is, Jim. Do you have a you had an announcement, right?
I can add something, Jim, really quickly.
Oh, yeah, sure.
In regards to the website, also, I don't think you had mentioned if people are able to do transcripts, write up some of the wording to some of the videos. We have Galactic Blessings, things of that nature. You can go to that section of the website, contact Slava or Max, in order to help us out.
Absolutely.
Because we need people to transcribe.
And
yes.
Go ahead. Jim got the printouts of the book. We printed the book of transcripts. It's available for purchase. It's only the price for printing, so it's very cheap. And it is printed as requested. So basically, you order it, it's getting printed, you get in about 2 weeks a new book of transcripts of Tekkrr, Lakesh, and many others. And it's the link is on the website. So go check out the website. It's reorganized, and I think it's more functional these days. Jim has been. Jim, how was your seclusion retreat sabbatical?
Yes, I went on a retreat. It was not what I expected, actually. I expected it to be a little bit more organized, but it was more free-flowing, and it was some days I was very third-dimensional. Other days, like for maybe 2 or 3 days in a row, I was like weeping and crying because they put the burdens of the earth on you and brought you into submission to a lot of things. And then some days were very angry, purging the anger out of your system. Some days were very introspective, where I just was thinking about what things should have been done, what things need to be done. Elijah was there a couple of days, who is my new higher self coming. But there was a couple of days that were just very normal, very third dimensional, very unlike anything special at all, but yet those were there to give me a little break from the times that that I was going to be emotional or going to be in introspection and things of that nature. So it was very good, excellent. I did learn a lot, and I think everybody around me was doing similar things at the same time. It was very interesting because I don't think it. I think it had to be planned that way by God in some ways, because not everybody could just fall into place with that kind of thought process all at the same time. But also, I wanted to say, those of you that were experiencing that kind of thing, it is to prepare you for the fourth dimensional energy that's coming, so that you can be more balanced and stable when it comes. A lot of people have been asking about it. And Tekkrr will come and give an update on the meetings that happened at the beginning of August and also the fourth dimensional energy. And then other people will come, I hope. So.
Wonderful, Jim.
Thank you.
Thank you. You also wanted to mention their channel panel.
Ah, the channel panel is going to be October 8th and 9th. I think it's mostly selected now. There's 14 people selected for it. I think they chose the final one yesterday or maybe 2 days ago. And so it's all set. And there's some amazing people on there that I'm really looking forward to listening to. And I'm going to be on it this year, and I hope a lot of you will tune in to listen, because according to what I've been being told, it's going to be a very, very, very special message this year. And it is going to be for a greater audience in the sense that you are my Hucolo audience, and you have heard me many times say many things. This is going to be a farther reaching in some ways, and that I find to be, how can that be? So, but that's what I was told.
Mm-hmm. Yay!
Yes.
So yes, we want to unite with other channelers. We want to reconnect with other communities. We are building a grid. We're building a grid of light workers. It's great we are getting connected. It's great you're becoming part of their grid as well.
Right.
Nice they invite you, and nice they recognize you.
Thank you. I feel very honored, really, because it's some of the very best that are out there. Brad Johnson and Rob Gauthier are two of my favorites, so, and they're both there, so I really really feel honored to be on a panel with them.
That's the plan. That's the plan. We reunite, we connect, build a grid. So we have paid classes now, and we have free webinars, which we do volunteering our time, and there is some money involved in support of the website and on things of that sort. And we invite donations. The donations will go to payments for the website hosting and to Slava and for other projects. So you go on the humancolony.org site, click donate. There is lots of options, but basically you can donate to specific people, or you can donate to specific projects, or to Human Colony. To Human Colony as a community, and this would be spent on the communal efforts. Some people, so we are spreading wide. Some people start their own channels, and some people come back. So we welcome everybody. We love everybody. We are all part of the big plan. So we will create the grid and uplift the earth. So that's the plan, and it will go for years, and we have a mission to accomplish. Any blessings before we start? Yeah, the invitations. Slava invited someone from the colony, so apparently Tekkrr, that would be it. I had many ideas who I wanted to invite. Like Jesus was, like, as usual, number one. Krishna. I never spoke to Krishna yet. I miss humans from the colonies as well. I miss Lakesh and Grindel. Jim, I never spoke to your Egyptian higher self, Egyptian god. I think his name was Seth?
My higher self name is Malachi at this time.
Uh-huh. But were connected to an Egyptian god.
Seth is one of the other spirit guides, yes.
Oh, spirit guides. So that would be interesting to speak to Seth, too.
We do have a few requests on the event page. I'll mention them, but it sounds like we do have a lie-up. There was a request for Nefertiti, mm-hmm. and also Lord Vishnu are the two requests I saw. So I wanted to mention that. And we have a few questions lining up. Also, I think that Brian was looking to do a blessing beforehand. Would anyone else be interested to do a blessing?
Yes, I will do that. Yeah.
Okay. Sounds good. All right. Anything else before we get started then?
Just to say that the book that I received that was published is all poetry from all the different aliens that were transcribed into the book. So I just wanted to let you know it's really interesting.
And it's not just roses are red, violets are blue. Some of these poems are very deep and profound. And when you really get into them and you read them, you really see a whole nother level to their reality. It's really beautiful. We read them very closely.
So
twice.
And keep in mind, it's the vibration between the words. There is second layer of vibration which uplifts you. Yep, it's the quality of the poetry. It's not only the first level. It's like multiple layers.
Multiple layers in there.
And thank you all transcribers who contributed. Mostly it was Liney and the group around here. Thank you all. Thank you all for becoming the part of one. Thank you, everybody. Your loves. You are blessed. The Divine Mother, the Great Mother, is with you. You are blessed with the word. You are blessed with the message. You are blessed with the opportunity. Breathe in the air. Enjoy the vibrations. The drama is for you to enjoy. The drama is for you to learn the lessons. The drama is an illusion, and take it as a gift. We don't take sides. We cherish your bravery. We cherish every little sparkle of life. Be part of the drama. Make wise choices. Be kind to everyone and shine. You have the opportunity to become, you have the opportunity to turn it the way you like and play it with love. You're loved. You're cherished. You have all the magic at your disposal. Amen.
Can you all hear me okay?
Yes.
Yes, greetings, everybody.
Greetings.
Iliokotonua. Iliadna nasakaitia. Iliokoto tosho huyata ye. Ilianani kia kokua. Ileshilianani kia koku. Itani. Ialiokotua. Shalani yukukua kia. Shatanane. Iliotokua. Isanana. Dolo tokuati. In Yakokuata, Shanana Yokoa.
All things separate actually are one. All actions separated by space, time, and elements are all one. They all move in one direction. They all create one huge scenario. There is not just one part of life, but there are infinite parts of life. There is not just one part of who you are, but there are infinite parts of who you are in different places and different times. There are different elements all around you, but they are all one. The oneness of all things is what makes everything move together. What makes everything move together and makes everything part of what it is. You must understand that when you are together as a group, you are not alone, and you are not just one, and you are not just many, but you are all things put together to make a grander scenario, to bring about a greater change. And when one change happens, it's not one change, but many changes. It is not just one thought, but many thoughts, and not just one scenario, but the scenario of all things is many scenarios put into one picture.
That was awesome. Thank you, Jim. Thank you, Brian and Max. Would anyone else be interested in doing a blessing? Otherwise, we can move right in.
Very good. Well, anybody else first?
I think that'll be it right now, Jim. So I believe we can go ahead and get started. We do have a few questions lined up here. So looking forward to it.
Very good. I know that Tekkrr is coming first. She wants to give you updates, and so therefore, hopefully, she can get in and out. I'm not sure how many questions you have for Tekkrr, but she just wants to give the update and then move on. So, one moment while I do a meditation. Yakwa. I'm Tekkrr. Greetings.
greetings.
Good morning, Tekkrr. Thank you.
Thank you for having me. I wanted to come and give you a couple of pieces of information about how the meetings with the governments went. More of you were there than ever before. There were 30-plus humans that attended the conferences with the humans that lasted from August 1st to August almost, well, into August 5th. It was only supposed to be a three-day get-together. However, people came and people went, and it lasted for almost 5 days. 4 days and 8 hours, to be exact. Many, many things were discussed, and many of you spoke. And as you were speaking, they understood your desires and your passion for the things that you wanted. Many people spoke on first contact. Many people spoke on sight to sight. Many people spoke on the hybridization program. Many people spoke on weaponry and peace on Earth. Many people spoke about interdimensional fighting and wars that are happening in other dimensions with your secret space programs. Other people spoke on a variety of different subjects that they were made aware of from different areas of your planet and different sources. They are becoming aware that your people are not just uninformed anymore. They are becoming aware that they need to do something because the information that is out there is becoming very much more available, and it is being sought after in a greater way than ever before. They understood the very first thing that they took into consideration this time, which I found to be most hopeful for us, is the medical programs. They were thinking that some people should be sent to the colonies for healing, for operations, for medical healings of all kinds. But still, they are saying that only their people, the government families and the government peoples, should be the ones that enjoy this benefit. But we said no. It must be everyone or no one. But it appears to us, and we cannot read their minds, however, it does appear that they are considering that, and that that might be the beginning of the site-to-site program. Now, just bringing people site-to-site has not been approved, of course. However, it's every time we speak of it, it becomes a longer subject. We speak about it for a longer period of time. We speak about it in different kinds of terms. We speak about it in localizations. We speak a lot about it in how to organize something of this nature. And they do not seem to act like they're that interested in doing it right now. However, there are so many questions that they have and so much information that's coming forth about what they want to do with that if it ever happens. So that makes us believe that eventually they will give in to that as well. First contact is a very big subject with them because they're afraid that the people will be extremely frightened and not understand. At this point, yes. But there will come a point in the near future, within the 4 or 5 years, where more people will be aware, where more people will be exposed to information that will bring a little bit more clarity to who we are. There are movies out now that portray good aliens and bad aliens. This is the first time that we've seen that good aliens are being portrayed in movies in a greater sense. I'm not sure if you were aware of that or not, but they are being seen as more positive. I believe that influence has come from us and from our colleagues that are working around the globe to speak to some of those producers and writers so that they can input positive alien contact in with the work of some of the more scary aliens that are negative. Now, having said that, there are still more negative aliens in the limelight than there are positive. But we are seeing some changes, and we are seeing the movement of some positivity on your planet towards embracing the fact that aliens can be good and that they can be positive. And this gives us great excitement and great hope for the future. I know that there are many, many subjects that were dealt with in the conference, and several of you spoke. At least 20 humans spoke their mind, and some of the subject matter was very diverse. And therefore, I was very proud of the human race for their preparation, even if it was in the astral and not in the physical, that they did a great job to communicate to those world leaders that they are interested in the future. They are interested in this present time also, and that they are interested in moving forward in a way that will help the galaxy. They are aware, you are aware, I should say, and make the governments more aware of how special Earth is to the galaxy and the universe. I cannot go into all the different things that were discussed. However, I'm sure that there are some questions. Please ask specific questions so that I can give you a specific answer on that particular subject. I know that many are still very curious about many different subjects that were discussed.
Okay, thank you so much, Tekkrr. The first question I'd like to get in here quick is from Leander on the event page, asking what the current energies are, if there's going to be first contact in 2020, and also what one is able to do with the scalar field generator that is listed on the Girk Fitneer website. So if you could go into detail on either of those.
Well, I am not aware of the generator, but I know the answer to the other questions. First of all, what was the first? Ask the first question again.
What the current energies are, if there's going to be first contact in 2020.
Yes, those two questions I can answer. Right now, their current energies, I'm wondering if many of you are feeling tired and exhausted. Many of you are feeling that your energies are just not what they used to be. I've heard many people speak to Jim and to other people about the fact that their energy is not up to par. The Earth energies are much faster now. They're speeding up in some ways to become more evolved. And so therefore, you are not used to having this fast of energy around, and it makes you feel tired, makes you feel lethargic, makes you feel that you are not part of that energy. But it is part of your evolution to move slowly and upgrade your system so that you can accept this energy into your life. So that is why you're feeling tired. That is why you are feeling, some of you are feeling tired. Some of you have already embraced this energy and are feeling a more energetic side to yourself, a more creative, a more clarity, some of these things. But many of you are still coming into this energy. Many of you are still dealing with the change of energy that happened in June. So therefore, late June, I should say. So therefore, it has not been that long since this energy has started moving faster. So do not be upset about that. It is on a perfect timing with the fourth dimensional energy that is coming. I don't know how it managed to be that way, but it is. And that energy, that fourth dimensional energy, will actually help you to bring that into your system, bring that into your reality, and make you feel a little bit better. There will be some that will continue to experience some lethargic and some laziness, if you will, even during the beginning of the fourth dimensional energy, because their systems have not been with the fourth dimensional energy as strongly, and that is all right. It is made for each individual person, and that does not mean you will not be a great person. It does not mean that your fourth dimensional energy will be any less than anyone else's, but it's just the way that you have to handle it as an individual. Also, the second part of the question was, 2020, first contact. I have so many things on my mind right now, you'll have to forgive me, because there are many things that we must discuss. But first contact in 2020 or 2021 does look possible, but your Earth governments are thinking that it doesn't seem that it could be possible. But we are seeing some greater movement in the Earth thought processes and greater movement in the positivity in some areas. So it is possible. We will not say that it is not possible. But I would love to see that happen. I would love to be connected directly to Earth by 2020 or 2021. We cannot verify that this will happen. As you know, the future cannot be predicted 100%. There are too many variables. I know that God would have some insight to some of these variables, but as a species in outer space or beyond your planet, we can only see what we can see in this scenario.
Okay, that makes sense, and let's go ahead and walk into that timeline where that is happening sooner rather than later.
Yes. We would love to see you move to that timeline, yes.
Yes, everybody, collectively, let's go. Okay, enough of the pep talk. So next, I think we have a question from Max for Slava.
All right. Slava is asking a personal question. Are you good with personal questions now, Tekkrr?
Will it help the general public if I ask it? Answer it.
I think everything connected to Slava helps because it gives a perspective, and wonderful Excellent. Loving perspective. So Slava asks, just recently, yesterday, I remember someone like feline being, it seems like we are contacted like telepathically, contacted like telepathically, or at least I perceive it like telepathically. I wonder if it was my daughter. I'm not sure, but I know that I visited her before, and I believe there was her mother as well. Yes. Hope she is fine.
You're always visiting your children, and you have quite a few at this point, because you've asked for quite a few. And yes, it was your daughter, and yes, you do have great perceptions of your family in off-world scenarios. Therefore, yes. It was your daughter.
Oh, thank you. I have a general question now. Several general questions which I think are nice prompts which you expect. So how were the participants of the meeting, of this August 1st to 5 meeting, how the participants were selected? Was it by aliens or by governments? Who selected them?
No. They volunteered, and we took those that volunteered. Some also volunteered to speak, and we took them as well. Now, we asked some to speak, and we asked some to come that did not volunteer, so it was selected by us as well, because we knew that they had information that was important to give to the governments. And so 90% were volunteers, but 10% were selected by us.
So Lightworkers were participating as a holographic projection, and government people were present in physical?
Yes.
And it was all on the surface of the Earth?
Yes. Now, I wanted to let you know something right off. It seemed like at first, well, it was at first, that there was not as great a population of the Earth's governments there as usual. But by the second day, they were all there in fullness. However, we found it a little disheartening that the first day there were seven nations missing that usually attended.
Wonderful.
But they have the second day.
Wonderful. As you remember, I suggested you have a constant ongoing conversation. Whenever, you know, whenever it becomes possible, whenever there is interest from the governments, maybe there could be a place where there would be always an alien representative ready to answer questions. So they would have like a hotline, a live person. Maybe they could take maybe you aliens can take turn and have like one or more people, one or more aliens available for answering questions at any time.
Yes, we do have some countries and governments do have ongoing conversations with us that are not during these particular times. But it's usually only very important questions, and usually only questions that come from fear of attack. They know, they see that there are so many ships, or there were. Actually, there's a lot less right now because all fourth dimensional ships have left the solar system at this point. Fictional energy cloud is very strong, but they did notice so many ships, and they had questions about the intentions of so many ships. And we spoke to about nine different governments about our intentions, and they're all positive. Now, we are no longer part of in the solar system right now. We are several hundred thousand miles outside the solar system due to the cloud, but we can still communicate with you. We just do not want to be pulled into the cloud of energy.
I think you misspoke the distance. Can you repeat the distance?
Pardon me?
You said a very small distance. I think it didn't make sense astronomically. You said you are away from solar system, but then named the distance, which is very small.
Yes, it is. It's the smallest distance right now that we can be away.
Okay.
But all right, you see, the cloud is not in your solar system yet. But we are on the opposite direction, 300,000 miles.
Thank you. Next question. Whereas
we were right in between the Earth and the Moon at one time, and that is only a short distance. Not even, we were less than 100,000 miles from the Earth at one point. Now we're 300,000 miles away.
Thank you. At some point, another channel said that the aliens would be coming down and visiting the groups of lightworkers. So we're expecting for this form of contact. How far that plan? Can you comment on that plan? Is it already becoming a reality? Can we see you in person, you and other aliens in person down here?
No, that will not happen. That was a misspoke. There will be aliens around the Earth still, those that are in fifth dimension, third dimension, and higher dimensions. Fourth dimension will not be around. But these people that want aliens to be on the Earth are wishful thinking. They cannot be there without your government permission.
Thank you. The earthquakes. Can you comment on the earthquakes?
There are many. There are many things happening on your planet. If you were to look at the universe of your entire planet as a whole, it would appear that it is a destruction area. There are many things happening in many different places. Fires, floods, earthquakes, different things of that nature. We are helping as much as we can in as many ways as possible.
Thank you. Tomorrow we'll be talking about the coming potential disasters. Is the number 2027, the year 2027, is still a likely year for the economic collapse?
No. Actually, they have moved it up. It will be much sooner than that, as far as they can see.
Thank you. We had a little insight what will happen after the collapse. How do we go up? Do you have any comment what economic system will be built after that? What is the nature of the new world?
It depends on who takes control after the collapse is over. There are several different powers vying for the control of the Earth after the collapse. The Cabal, Anunnaki in some ways, some of the plans are secretive. Your governments are also planning for this because they know that it is coming. Many of your Earth people would plan to reinstate a monetary system, and the Cabal would go along with that because that is what they know the best. However, other thought processes are also involved to bring out a new era of change for humanity so that they are not separated, that they are more connected, more united, and do not need monetary as their main source of survival. They can use several different means to move forward. This would be the most acceptable for us. But of course, it is up to you on which means you do accept. We cannot interfere with that.
Thank you. That is most insightful. We were waiting for this answer, and it answers a lot of our questions. I pass the microphone. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Okay, thank you. Next, we have a question from Krellick.
Yes, hello.
Greetings, Krellick.
Yes, hello, Tekkrr. I've been looking at some official news media sites, and they are talking about how scientists have discovered an Earth-like planet. I wanted to know if you were able to comment on this.
We have discovered 36,482 Earth-like planets. So yes, there are many out there. So therefore, yes, they have discovered this planet, and they call it the second Earth, some of them do. And some of them call it Earth 2, and they have many cute names for it. However, there it is a planet that has life on it, but the life on it is primitive.
Would this be a step towards disclosure?
Well, it would be if there was greater life on this planet. But as far as they can see, there is nothing but trees, plants, and things, and animals on this planet. There is no civilization that they are aware of. Now, some of the animals on this planet are actually a civilization that is intelligent, but they cannot tell that from their distance.
I have a second question about Lyran society. About what happens when a Lyran becomes an adult.
Well, whenever anyone becomes an adult in any society, there's usually some kind of celebration, some kind of notice that is given to that individual. The reason for that is, and the reason that you also do it, is because you want to recognize that they're coming into a greater means of responsibility, a greater time in their life when they are going to notice changes. And you do not want them to be ignoring these things or thinking that they are alone in this change process. So therefore, you bring attention to it so that they do not feel uncomfortable with it. And so that is what happens with our society as well. We bring into the light that you are going through these changes. Now, the changes that a Lyran would go through are much different than the changes a human would go through. A human develops more hair and things of this nature. We already have hair. We have hair everywhere. So that is not one of the changes that would happen with us. So it would be more of a psychological. There is some physical changes, but we do draw attention to them so that they do not feel that they're uncomfortable with these changes. Do you understand that? But they also see, when they're younger, that there is a difference between youth and adulthood. So, but to call attention to this change makes them feel more comfortable about themselves if you call this change into view in a proper way, not in an embarrassing way, in a very successful way, as if you're moving from one period to another and it's going to be a very successful and smooth transition.
Thank you. I do have one final personal question, but I'm not sure if you are taking those currently.
It depends. Continue.
Well, it's mostly about if there's any important information that I should know.
Important information can be very general. Everybody can know that have the same important information coming to them. Like, be prepared for the fourth dimensional energy. So, yes, that piece of information I would continue to stress, because some people will feel it much stronger than others. And some will actually go through it without much thought about it at all. And others are constantly having deja vus and Mandela effects. Depending on the individual, the psyche, the way that it is affecting the fourth dimensional energy in the brain, that is what will happen. Now, the thing that I want to bring to you is that you are getting closer and closer to understanding alien processes. You seem to be experiencing a lot of alien processes. And so, as a human being, you are closer to understanding some of the alien processes than other people, because they visit you a lot in the astral, and you visit their planets in the astral. And so there, I congratulate you for that. You are ahead of the curve for understanding alien cultures. But there are others of you that are going to start experiencing that. In your sleep periods, in your astral times, you're going to start experiencing alien cultures. Many of you already have. Embrace that, because when you learn the protocols to speak to other species and beings, it will be helpful to know a little bit about their culture. So remember as much as you can. I know many of you try to remember as much as possible, and it is sometimes impossible. But I think that will open up a little more with this fourth dimensional energy coming. I believe most of the time the reason why you do not remember things is because you believe that what you experienced did not exist. We're starting to understand that you did not believe it. It was like, was that real or was that not? Now we're going to help you to believe it more. When you come here in the astral, we are telling people, believe that you are here. We're telling you to believe in what you are experiencing now. And believe it or not, more people are starting to recall where they have been, because now they are starting to believe it.
Yes, thank you for that. And I'm hoping that I can talk with you privately in the future.
Excellent. And that would be a joy for me as well.
Okay, thank you. I wanted to throw this question in here quickly, because a lot of people are asking. So the question I had read earlier regarding the scalar field generator from Leander, saying, what can one do with a scalar field generator? This is the crystal program, scalar field, energy vortex thing that that Peter had posted on the Girk Fitneer website. And yes, I think a lot of people are very curious if you'd be able to talk a little bit more about what it can do, because it looks like it's going into its beta test, or not beta, but it is now on sale.
Well, one thing, I have to admit that I am not much interested in human technology. So that is why I do not know a lot about it. But I know that it is an energy conductor as well as an energy producer, energy releaser. I'm not sure how to say that. But it releases energy and it brings energy to itself. It's like the Tesla coil in some ways. It generates, I believe that Tesla coil is in it, maybe. But anyway, it is part of the advancing of your technology to the basis for energy-based technology, such as vibrational technology, meaning that it can embrace vibration, calculate it, study it, and capture it, and move it from one place to another. It can also take vibration and change it, which can be dangerous, but it can also do that. But that can also be a positive thing as well. I don't want to give too many examples of that because there are some people listening that might not use that in the most proper way. But it is your energy vortex that is created with it is strong, but you will find out that the future conceptions of this particular generator will be much stronger and do much more. But they can do quite a bit. I'm not sure that I'm allowed to tell you what you can do, all the things that you can do with it, because it is the basis for other inventions.
Okay, fascinating. Well, thank you for elaborating on that. I know a lot of people are excited about it, and I think it's a big step forward for us.
Well, there's a Tesla coil in this home as well.
Oh, great.
It is very powerful.
Yes, it is.
Yes, they will change the world, no doubt.
There are so many things that you can do. It is the beginning of many different energy inventions. What I mean by energy inventions is that it can change energy as well as create it.
Yes, I am so looking forward to that being used more in our future. I think we all are. So next up we have a question from Brian.
Greetings, Tekkrr. How are you, my friend?
I am very well, thank you.
Yes.
And how are you, Brian?
Good, good. Just feeling these energies. There are a lot of shift and change in the planet. I can feel it.
Yes, there is much.
Yes, my
that
question
is probably,
yes, go ahead.
That is part of the reason for the earthquakes,
yes,
and for the different catastrophes that are going on now. Mother Earth also has to get used to these energies as well as humanity.
Yes. But just two quick questions. The first being, during the meetings with the governments of the world, what was your sense, what was the breakthrough that you could feel that really really gave hope to the Girk Fitneer Alliance?
I'll tell you when humans are very cautious about what they say, not because of the aliens, but because of other humans, this tells me that their thought processes are not wanting to reveal what they are truly thinking. Does this make sense to you?
Yes.
So this told us that many of your governments, including the United States and Russia, were thinking that first contact is necessary very soon, and that alien interaction would be welcome, but they could not say that outright to the peoples of the world. So they disguised it or masked it in many ways by asking questions that would have a very positive answer from us. Do you understand that?
Oh, very much so.
So therefore, they asked a question that they knew actually the answer to, but that would also give other people a positive answer to a question that right now they are still feeling negative towards. This kind of psychology by some of your leaders is being used much more often in these government scenarios. I'm using that word a lot today. But anyway, you understand what I am saying, I am sure.
Yes, and what's amazing also is that your guys' ability, even on the ships, to see through that. You do see, you understand that, logically.
Having studied human psychology now for several years and have spoken to many different... I've spoken to probably 100 different humans. I'm getting an idea of how the human psychology works and how humans react to certain stimuli and things of that nature. We are understanding that you are part of who we are as well.
Yes.
We react very similarly to many of the same stimuli. So we are aware that there are some of your leaders that are very interested in connecting.
Good, good.
Now,
yes.
There was just a couple conferences ago, some of these leaders were very negative. And we understand why at this point. Because they could not say anything. They could only do certain things with the certain ways that they were being treated and looked at by the people and by the people around them. Some things have changed quite a bit since then. And so, therefore, they have changed their attitudes. Now, we are also aware that there are some leaders that have alien hybridization within them now. Yes. We were not allowed to scan them at one point. They forbid that any of the government people were allowed to be known for who they really were. And so we agreed to that because we are trying to stay as closely in line with what they want from us as possible. However, a few individuals on your planet that are in high government positions have given us permission to scan them and see who they really are. And interestingly enough, some of them are very highly alien and hybridizations.
Interesting. Very interesting.
And they are human-born alien hybridizations. Now, some higher than others, of course, but nothing compared to what you're going to see soon.
Wow. And my last question real quick to Kerr was, even as you're expanding, the Girk Fitneer Alliance itself,
yes.
Are you allowed at this time to reveal any more species that are willing or very close to joining the Girk Fitneer Alliance?
There is one species that is very close to joining and will probably be entering our alliance, at least a portion of their population. Now, let me tell you why the entire population is not joining. This particular species has many different ideas and philosophies, and so some of their species is wanting to join Girk Fitneer, and we are... The reason why they have not joined yet is because we are questioning whether this would divide their species, divide their population, and we would not want to do that by accepting them into our alliance and have them be divided from the rest of their peoples. So we are talking to the whole population about these certain ones that want to join Girk Fitneer because they feel that we are doing the right thing. Now, other parts of their population would not do what we are doing and feel that we are actually treading on the idea that we are breaking the promises or the very fine line between humans and aliens. Do you know what I'm speaking?
Yes.
Prime directive, as you call it.
Yes. It almost sounds kind of like Earth. Like you have a divide.
And they are definitely divided.
Yes.
But they are not divided in a way that will cause war or dissension. But they are divided in philosophy.
Are they allowed to be revealed at this time? Yes.
We will be bringing a sector of the Siri race into our alliance.
Is that close to... What is that the closest to, then? Like, for... are they close to Yahyel, Lyran type energy?
No, they're closest to 𝗪𝗘𝗕𝗜𝗡𝗔.
Oh, wow. Okay. Well, thank you so much. That's all I had, Tekkrr. Much love and light.
Yes, and at this point, we have not brought the Sirians into our alliance. I mentioned their name only because it is 95% likely that this section of their peoples will, their governments, will join us. But it is not going to be a negative thing for their civilization. In fact, I think it will be a growing time for them to share thoughts and to share all the thoughts of the people within our alliance as well. That will bring us to 7 in our alliance. And I believe it will help them to understand more beautifully other alien cultures.
Thank you very much. We are aware of our Syrian connections, and we love Syrians. We have spoken to them. We are welcome there. Closer connection now and their activity. You just said something which was interesting, provoking about our government leaders being a hybrids. Immediately, I'm thinking about most famous leaders and wonder what kind of hybrids could they be. Like we have, like there is
They gave us permission to scan them and let us know who they were, but they did not give us permission to tell you who they were.
Absolutely. What I'm saying is...
I think that you could probably imagine who they were, or are.
Yes. Just after that you said that it's nothing to what is coming. I assume that coming are more news that some leaders are even more alien, right?
I did not say that, but I am saying that there are those that are human-born that are more alien than some of your government officials.
All right. Thank you very much. I pass the microphone.
I'm sorry, Cher, I have a really quick question on that. I would like clarification. You say human-born. Do you mean like getting alien DNA infusions or the more violent way that I've heard of, but I'm not sure?
No. These are those that were set up to be born into your population to help the growth of your race, and they have volunteered from other species to be born into the human race to help with the ascension.
Okay, I understand. Okay, thank you very much. Okay, Cher, go right ahead.
Hey, Tekkrr, much love.
Cher, how are you?
I'm very good, actually. I want to ask you a couple of questions. First of all, you mentioned the Sirian might join. What density are they at?
Sirians are in fifth density.
Okay.
Most of the population.
Mm-hmm.
If they are not in fifth density, they are in very high fourth. But we perceive them as fifth density.
I see.
As you would call them. Others would call them different densities. Many have learned different ways of seeing the different densities and learning about them. Which one is the most proper for you, we do not know.
Okay. I was wondering, when is the next meeting with the government, if there's a date
that
already?
That would be late November, early December.
Okay. And I was wondering which... date exactly is the cloud is going to arrive?
At this point, the 7th of December has been acclimated or I mean, has been foreseen as the day that it will actually enter the Earth atmosphere.
7th of December?
7th of September.
No, a day after my birthday.
Good for you.
Hmm?
You'll get a fourth dimensional surprise party.
I actually was wondering about it. Many things in Judaism happens in September, October, like the blood moon and the holidays, and many things occur during that time, also the cloud, and my birthday. So is there a reason for that?
We believe that there is. What all the reasons for it, we do not know, because the cloud or field or whatever you want to call it was not predicted by anyone. And so what its main function is going to be a little bit of a surprise. But we are believing that it is going to be a positive surprise to help offset some of the negative things that we know are going to happen.
I see. And is it going to be wiser to ask questions about when first contact is going to arrive, or when the economy is going to collapse, only after the cloud, after we will know what we're facing for?
We are not sure how the cloud will affect these things.
So it would be wiser to ask them after.
There will be some effect. And so many of the things that have been said about all these different predictions that have been made, some things could be changed by the very presence of this extremely high fourth dimensional energy.
Okay. Thank you very, very much, and much, 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 much love to you.
Much love to you as well. Is it time for someone else to come?
It depends on how you're doing. Do you need to go? We have a few more questions.
If there are a few more questions, I will take them.
Okay. Next, we have a question from Ade.
Greetings, Ade.
Hi, Tekkrr. Blessings.
Blessings.
I want to ask you about the situation all over Africa. It seems like the Reptilians and the Nordics have a stronghold on Africa and affecting it in a very negative way. And it seems like sending it light helps a little bit, but we go in circles. Like, there is resolution and then the same conflict arises again. So is there anything being done on your end to help the situation?
We are not allowed to help these situations. This would be a violation of our treaty with your governments. However, we see what is happening. It is positive for the aliens that exist there to do what they are doing, but it is negative for the humans. There are many men in black headed that direction to try to clear up that situation. You see, they have now become aware that some of these reptilians are not there, not by permission. At first, they were grandfathered in because they were there many years before some of the treaties and agreements were made. But now, they must follow what has been put into those agreements and treaties, and they are not doing so. So they are going to be dealt with, and things should clear up in some ways, yes.
Is there anything that we can do on our end to help the situation?
Prayer, of course, and sending positive energy into that country. There is a lot of negative energy there, but the people believe that that negative energy should exist. They believe that it exists for their protection in some ways. Some of the belief systems in that area of your world are very unusual and bring fear and negative energy to them, and they feel that it is going to be used in a positive way. So I cannot actually comprehend it completely, but the belief systems are very disturbing, and they need to be, some of them need to be awakened and to the reality of what is happening with their belief systems.
Yes, I agree. I don't understand it either. Thank you. That was my question. And thank you. Blessings.
You are welcome. Blessings.
Okay, thank you. Next we have a question from Barbara. She'd like to ask, this morning I saw a figure outside my window in shadow form. It was there for a moment. I was wondering if you could tell me who it was, and was it maybe my friend in the woods?
Spiracles. It was Spiracles.
Okay, I think she has left, so she will probably hear this at some point. Thank you.
You will know who that is. That is her friend in the woods.
Perfect. Okay.
And she knows his name.
Awesome. Okay, next we have a question from Angie. She was curious if you would be able to tell her anything, any explanation in regards to what she's dreaming about. She said she keeps dreaming. She's running and jumping off a building to her death, but she always wakes up right before landing, and she says she is not suicidal.
No. This is not about jumping to your death. This is about a leap of faith. It is something that you are thinking about doing that makes you feel insecure. It is not about death at all. It is about something that you are planning or something that you are thinking about doing that is causing you to feel unsafe, that you, the waters are not tested. It's going to be like a leap of faith, something that you're planning to do that you are not sure what the outcome is or what is actually going to be happening with that. But yet it is something that you are moving forward in your spiritual journey in your third dimension and fourth dimension. It's all inclusive of these things. Do you understand?
Okay.
Therefore, that is why you wake up before you die, is because you are not to die. You are to be, you just do not know what happens after that point. But it is a leap of faith.
Okay, she says perfect, thank you. Next, since we're on the topic of dreams, Cher had a question, quick.
Hey, Tekkrr. Well, I have many, many dreams lately, but on the morning of the...
Yes, I know. Continue.
On the morning of the 13th this month, I actually wake up, took the Alpha Brain, which I spoke with you about, went back to sleep for 2 more hours, and I had a very vivid dream about me using telekinesis on quite large objects. And I remember, like, just focusing about something, having the intention to move, and all of a sudden it will move very fast and immediately, like a branch or something like that. There was something with me. It was my boss from work, but I'm pretty sure it was just an ET disguising.
Let me tell you what that is about. It is not about telekinesis at all, but it is about opening doors on your future. There very soon will be many doors that will fly open because you will them to. You are opening doors in your mind. You are opening doors in third dimension. You are needing to be a place where you are not yet. And this is letting you know that there will be a time coming soon that you will be able to open these doors without much effort.
Open them for
you to step through.
For the future.
Correct.
Okay. Thank you very much, and as always, much, much, much love to you.
Much love.
Okay, thank you. Next, we have a question from Liliana.
Hi, how are you?
I am wonderful. And yourself?
I'm all right, thank you. Thank you for coming today.
Thank you.
My question for you is, what are your insights or what do you know about the substance found in San Francisco de Rincón de Guanajuato in Mexico, in the house of Sol Collazos Ayala? I would like to know more about that substance, if you know.
I'm not sure I understood the question completely.
Well, there was there are some beings going to Mexico. They are found specifically in San Francisco del Rincón de Guanajuato, and they are like light beings, and they are turning into beings, yeah, like physical beings, and
yes.
I would like to know where they come from and everything.
And you wonder what they are doing.
Yes, please.
They are on a spiritual journey right now. There are some portholes that need to be opened where they are going. But that is not the extent, that is not the full extent of their journey. They are also looking for a particular area that has some artifacts from their ancestry. There are some ancestry issues there. And they are going on a spiritual trek, but also a trek to find some of their ancestral relics. Some of these relics are very powerful.
Is there any way we can connect with them? Or are they
I have connected with them a couple times because they have let themselves be known to the world. And so, therefore, I did speak to them, and this is what they told me. However, they would not tell me what relics they are looking for. This is very personal to them. But, yes, you can connect to them if you wish. They will be happy to speak, but they would not probably give you information about the relics that they are seeking. But they would tell you about their spiritual journey and why now is an important time for them. Now is an important time for them also because of all the different energies that have been introduced to the Earth and the fourth dimensional energy. In their particular society, there was something that alluded to the fourth dimensional energy cloud that is here, going to be here on your world very shortly. And so they took that as, it did not say a fourth dimensional energy cloud, but it was a movement of space that they would interpret to mean that this cloud was the right time for them to move in this particular way.
can I know where they come from?
If they allow me to tell you, I will tell you, but I have not connected with them right this moment.
All right. Thank you.
You are welcome. I would not want to break protocol with them.
Okay. Thank you. Next, we have a question. Next, we have a question from Louise asking if you're able to answer which aliens are in charge of South America and what are they working with?
There are many aliens that are attached to South America. It is probably the most visited of all the continents on your planet because it is the one that has the most free space that is amicable to their kind. The rainforests and things of this nature are very home-like to many species because many of the species are from tropical areas and you will find that there's many different kinds of plant, animal, and insect life there, and they study that on a continuing basis. The reason why they go there is to study Earth and to study the things of Earth that are from the ancient past. There's Machu Picchu, there's Lake Titicaca with the alien island in the middle. There is Easter Island. There is Ponkapiku. I don't know how to say that one. But and it is where many aliens, there's the Nazca lines, etc. So many things that are there from their past. So they're actually just studying their own ancient past.
Okay. Interesting. Thank you.
You will find that the humans that live in South America do not speak about aliens very often. And the reason why they don't is because they experience aliens more than anyone else. And so it's not something they want to talk about.
Oh, I see. Okay. All right, next question we have is from Jonah. She's asking, I have been getting a strong feeling that we are going to get some new senses that people call, quote, superpowers. Can you elaborate on it, if it is going to happen soon, and how we can allow it? Thank you.
What you are feeling is the opening of the other portions of the brain. You see, humans only use a very small portion of the brain. And in the other portions of the brain, there are many different gifts that are not open to humans. Telekinesis, the ability to heal yourself, to grow appendages, to have psychic conversations, to move from one place to another in the physical realm. There are many different gifts inside the brain that are not yet to be opened. But you are getting the insight that they are there. You know that they are there. You feel them in a stronger way than you ever have, because the fourth dimensional energy is sort of caressing those portions of the brain in the human mind only to enhance the belief systems so that one day they may open. There are some humans on Earth right now that do have the ability to open one or two of these places. Another one of those things is being a channeler and open yourself to be able to channel things from other places. And that is one of the gifts that is being opened to humans now, and to be able to be effective with yourselves, with telepathy, with knowing how other people feel, being very telepathic that way. There are many different things that are opening up to humans that were very closed to them before. You see, in this era that you are in, since the year probably 1990 or thereafter, things started to open a little bit more quickly in the mental areas of human beings. And so now you are here in your year 2016, and you are experiencing channeling, empathic abilities, telepathic abilities, the ability to, some of you travel astrally at will, some of them bilocate, some people are learning all different kinds of things that were never even discussed before, except for in the realms of mysterious actions. And and whenever there were discussed in a mysterious action, it was usually said, oh, that's evil. And the reason they said that is because the fear of the unknown causes fear to be the main educator, if you will. And so when you're afraid of the unknown, it educates you to be afraid of it. So it educates the mind and says, oh, I don't know anything about that, so it must be bad. But many of you are opening up to the different elements of the brain now, the different diversities that the mind holds. and therefore you are not afraid of it any longer. Well, some of you still are, but you're becoming less afraid of it because you're seeing it. You see, your reality and your experience is creating a belief. And some of you believed before there was a reality or an experience. And so there's a very great teaching to come out about the belief system that will help you to be able to bring more things to you and bring more positive opening of the brain cells to you in a coming time. And that will be written down. It will be about reality, experience, and beliefs. And they're all associated, of course. Yita.
Okay. Thank you. So in regards to that, Jonah was also asking why she feels it so strong right now. I know that the energies have a lot to do with this, so then wouldn't the upcoming wave...
The reason she is personally feeling it so strongly is because she has believed in many things for a great deal of time and have opened herself up to many different positive things and has been very curious about how to move forward in these things. And they are just giving you the awareness that, yes, it is possible for you to do some things. And it may not be all the things that you are thinking of, but you are opening up to greater understandings and greater abilities.
Okay, wonderful. She says thank you so much. I would just like to step in quickly and say then, those who are looking to progress forward as far as raising frequency and everything in the ascension process with the upcoming fourth dimensional waves of energy that could potentially assist us in those ways as well, as far as opening up more to psychic abilities and teleportation and things of that nature, correct?
Yes.
Beautiful.
There's much to discuss about this.
Okay, is there anything in particular you would like to highlight before we move on?
No, I am fine.
Okay. Okay, great. Then next question we have is from Jess. She is asking, have the negative reptilian energies left, and what exactly was the healing energy I received this morning? I think she's talking just personally.
Yes, the negative reptilian energies are not there at this time. I do not sense them. The healing energy that you are feeling is that from those that are sending healing energy around the world right now. There are many that are in need, and you are experiencing the fallout of much energy that is being sent. However, in particular, there is someone sending you some very positive energy directly.
Okay, great. And to clarify, that was for Jess 444, so thank you for that. I have a quick question, but before I ask, it's just kind of general. I'm wondering how you're doing, how Jim's energy levels are doing, if anyone else wanted to come through.
I am doing fine, but there are others that are waiting.
Okay. I have a quick question about the colonies, and then maybe we can move on. We might get some more questions. My quick question is just in regards to, I have been remembering some of my astral travels recently as I sleep, which is very exciting. And I've been remembering meetings, quite a few meetings, where it's similar to how we felt at the Arkansas Hot Spring Retreat, where there's lots of people in a house. I'm wondering if you could give any sort of a clarification on the recent meeting. I think it was maybe about a week ago. I feel like I was in where there were lots of people, maybe around 30 or so. Were we discussing unification, things of that nature?
Of course. right now, I have to say that there are several different species that are having different conferences. The ones that you have been in conference with are the Hathors. You are a toner, you know how to do it, and you are one of their... with Sarah, you can speak the toning language and do different things. Also, you are attached to the elemental forces of this planet, and the Hathors are very much attached to their elemental forces on their planet as well. So you are a perfect candidate for them to speak to.
Wow, that is incredible. I was not aware. Thank you for that.
You're welcome.
Wonderful. So that's exciting. Sam had a quick interjection, was asking before you leave if you would be able to assist him with a Pleiadian infusion and to help with his ascension process.
It will be sent to him. Sam, where are you? Do you know where he is? Just get in contact with us, and we will be able to give you this infusion.
I'm right here, Dakar. I was just trying to make a quick move.
Yes. We will do a scan on you and see how much alien hybridization you have at this point. And if you have some Pleiadian in you, which I believe you probably do, we will increase it.
Great. Wonderful. Thank you.
Very well.
Much love to you, Dakar.
Much love.
Okay, thank you so much, Tekkrr. I don't think we have any more questions for you at this time. I know you said somebody else might want to come through.
Well, someone asked for Yeshua, and he is here.
Oh, wonderful. Okay, well, thank you so much for coming today. We love having you, as always.
Excellent. Thank you very much.
Namaste.
Namaste.
Namaste. Much love.
Greetings to you. This is Yeshua.
Good morning, Yeshua. Thank you for coming.
I have a small message. I know many of you are dealing with very many negativities. The third dimension deals harshly with humans sometimes. And sometimes it is just the way that it is. But let me tell you that you can make it through these harsh times in an easier way if you try to put a positive spin on it. You see, there is a reason for all things. There's a reason for even negativity, and that is to make the positivity look greater. But some people dwell in this negativity because they feel they have no way out of it. I know that some of you feel that way, and that it comes to you and is like so strong that you just cannot seem to lift out of it. But lift your eyes up these days, because it is not here to stay. It is not there for you to live in. It is not there for you to perpetuate. It is not there for you to bring to other people. But it is there so that you may learn how to move beyond it. And you say, well, how? How do we move beyond this negativity? First of all, when anyone falls into negativity, it is because it's been around, or they've been seeking something that is negative, or they have been involved in something negative, or they let themselves be put somewhere negative, some people saying something negative to them, to them, and they've accepted it as the truth, as that they are negative, or that there's something negative about them, they must understand that God is the soul. God is the soul. And He is light. He is not negative. He is not the down. He is not the oppressed. He is not the thing that you can't get out of. But when you call on Him, and if you mean every word you say when you call on Him, He will be there for you. And how does He pull you out of this? By letting you know how loved you are. And some of you do not feel loved. Some of you feel very alone. Some of you feel rejected. Some of you feel like there's hopelessness around. But I want to tell you, you are all genuinely and fully loved. You may not feel that, but if you accept that, accept that you are fully loved. Know that I love you, and know that you are fully loved. Darkness cannot stay. It will be a slow climb out of the negativity sometimes, sometimes quickly. But if you keep your eyes on that positivity, keep your eyes on the fact that you are loved, there is no way to stay down. There is no way to stay down. That is all I wanted to say. But I think it's very important right now, because a lot of people are feeling rejected, dejected, lonely, and disconnected. But that is only your thoughts. My thoughts, the thoughts of God, and many other people know that you are still connected, still a bright light, and still loved. And you may not feel like a bright light, but the soul of God is still in you, and that is connected to everyone, and that is a bright light. And we will all pull you forward. Keep your eyes on love and do kind things to others. Do not let the negativity that is possessing you be that you distribute. Try to distribute only the good, the love, the kindness, and that will pull you out of where you are at this time.
Thank you, Yeshua. I think that is the most crucial message I know I could hear right now, and I'm sure everybody else. It has been a very trying time. I'm sure astrological things and many other things are taken into account, the energies. So, yes, staying positive, absolutely. We do have a few questions lined up here. Are you able to answer some questions?
Yes, please.
Wonderful, thank you. First, we have a question from Michelle.
Michelle.
Hi. Good morning, Yeshua.
I love you, Michelle.
I love you, too. That was exactly what I was going to ask about to begin with. So that was really beautiful. Thank you for that message. I did want to address the idea. I noticed something about myself, kind of like feeling this pain patch, yes, that I am going through. And after talking it through with a couple of people, I noticed that, you know, when the energies were coming in and I could definitely feel angels and clearing and you and Mary and whatever, all of that felt so magnificent that when it quit, like maybe it's time, I don't even know why it quit. Like it quit because I'm ready to assimilate it is a question. Is that
it? You've already assimilated it. You know what it feels like. You remember it. It's, yeah, all there. It's inside. It's assimilated. Now you are back into the real life, as they call it. And guess what?
The it's pain really disappointing.
The pain is there, but the love is there also.
Yeah.
You have to understand that you can bring all those things that you assimilated into that third dimensional, droll, dry pain.
Right.
You know how? Because you can remember how much you are loved. You can remember how much they ministered to you. And give that ministry to somebody else if they need it. And guess what? It all returns. Because when you give, you receive 100 times more.
Mm, beautiful. Yeah, I think that was really just the beginning, because that feels so amazing. And when it goes away, I notice that I take it as I was special, but now I am not special. I know that's not correct, but that's what it felt like. And so,
you are always special. You are special healer, special communicator at times, and special love. You have special love that only you can give.
Well, I appreciate it. Thank you for being here.
And you know that is true, and I send you my love now, and I send you encouragement, because your path goes up and down, and I see that. But it is a path straight to the light, even though it may seem windy or up and down or curvy. You're straight ahead.
Thank you. Is there any directive you would like to give me? Something to focus on? Yes.
When you feel this way, when you feel that there is no special around, mm-hmm. Not that you're not special anymore. Think about your healing energies. Think about how much I love you and God loves you. And think about your beautiful girl, Brooke.
Okay. I love it. Thank you, Jeff. Thank you, Yeshua.
You're welcome.
Much love.
Much love. Always.
Thank you. Next we have a question from Shir.
Shalom, Yeshua. Ma nishma achi? How are you?
I am very well. Greetings.
I want to ask you something. I know that one of my guides, his name is Emmanuel, and someone once told me that it might be actually you, because you were known as Emmanuel as well at your time.
There are many aspects of me, and what I mean by that is you cannot comprehend fully who I am in one being. So therefore, yes, part of me is with you as a guide. And when I say aspect, I know people get confused about that. How can there be many aspects of you? But look at God. How many facets of his personality, how many different things he has created you can't even imagine. So you don't even know who he is in his fullness. And that is how I am as well. You cannot understand who I am until you've experienced everything about me. And that will take many, many, many lifetimes. And in fact, you will never experience everything that is me. But an aspect of me is with you. And that aspect is to teach you that thing about me that you need to incorporate.
I see. You also, once the first time that you came and I spoke with you, you said, oh, I know you. So that's what you meant? Because an aspect of you is my spiritual God?
Yes.
Okay. Yes. Okay, that's all I want to ask. Much love to you. And
much love.
Do you have any messages, maybe?
It would be personal, and I would not want to share it with everyone.
Ah, okay. And Can you also send Jim's father a healing energy? I know he needs it.
Jim's father?
Yes.
Oh, Jim's father.
Yeah.
He is on his way back to a normal situation.
Okay, thank you very much. And much love to you.
Much love to you, Shir.
Thank you so much. Next we have Megan.
Hi, Yeshua.
Greetings. How are you?
I'm very well, much love. I'm feeling you very strongly, and I know you're always with me, and I had a question about that. Sometimes you're in my meditations, and I wonder if you have any messages for me in particular, just now, yes. Or...
Actually, I can share this particular message with you, is that you're growing so quickly. You're feeling the energies of God, and your journey is coming into more focus now than it ever has before. Continue to do that, and I will continue to love you and guide you. And your thought processes are so beautiful, kind, and loving. I am so happy to be with you.
Thank you so much. I love you.
I love you as well. You will do very well. And there are many gifts that are still yet to open for you.
Are there any gifts that anything that I'm facing with, like, I feel like I'm facing some snags in the development process. Do you have any suggestions?
Yes, I do. The snags are because you are moving forward quickly and they wouldn't want you to do so. Snags are there so that people realize that they are going the right direction.
That resonates so strongly. Yes. Well, I will leave you at that, and then thank you so much for showing up today and for giving us all of your beautiful messages and your love.
Yes. Beware when there are no snags, because then it's too easy.
That is true.
But they want you to learn the lesson in the fullest possible way. So sometimes a snag helps you to relate to that part of the lesson that is needed to be learned.
Ah.
Much love.
Much love.
Thank you. Next, we have a question from Cross. Cross Nevermore is asking, not sure if it's an appropriate question, but would like to ask a little bit on the topic of negativity. What exactly is one supposed to do when they are attached to the hip of an entity of negative energy, or other way around, maybe. Cross said in particular, things have been very hard at this time.
I understand. There are many questions I need to ask before I can answer that. First of all, how are you attached? Did you attach yourself? Did it attach itself to you? Is this attachment something that you want, or is it something that said it wanted you? Is this attachment something that you want to get rid of, or is it actually something that helps you grow because it keeps your positivity moving the other direction and feeling better about it because the negativity shows you how strong the positivity is? Or does the negativity make the positivity seem small? See, there's many questions, but what I see attached to you is that you need to get rid of this. You feel attached to it only because you believe that it is attached. It cannot otherwise be there. Your belief system tells you what to believe. And if you say, there is a negative attachment on me, that means you believe it. That means it is there. That means you have in some way, not completely, but in some way accepted it as being there. Now, I would love to talk to you about this because I see that negativity is something that sort of entices you. It makes you wonder about it, the power of it, the imagination of it, the fullness of it. Whereas sometimes the light and love and goodness seems a little wishy-washy to you, but let me put this in perspective. The light can destroy that negative entity in a flash. The light is full of invention. The light is in full of love. The light is full of positive ideas and advancement, opportunity, moving forward, and getting the things that you really want. Negativity gives you a sense of power and sometimes a sense of accomplishment that is not really true. You may say, aha, but it's given me I'm able to move a rock because negativity is on my side. But positivity can move a mountain.
Okay, thank you. This is very profound, I think, for a lot of people. Cross had mentioned, did not intend to get rid of it, so he can help me grow further. So I thought that was an interesting statement, if you would like to.
And I understood that. That is why I said what I said.
Right. Okay. Okay, wonderful. Thank you so much for that. Next, we have a question from Max.
Max, you are not being heard. Turn your microphone on.
Still can't hear you, Max. I'm not sure why. You are not muted, as far as I can see. Okay, well, in the meantime, I will go to the next person and hopefully go back to Max. Might have to jump out and jump back in, Max. Next, we have a question from Jonah Lee.
Greetings.
Okay.
Hello?
Jonah Lee.
That everyone is silent at this time.
Yeah, it seems as much.
Perhaps that is an indicator that God wants us to move on and that today is not any longer.
Okay. Yeah, sure. We can wrap it up. Absolutely.
I believe there are some blessings to be given, though.
Yes, please. If there are any blessings in the room, if anyone would like to give a blessing, or if you would like to, please.
Before I go, I would like to give a blessing to this group, and then I will be on my way. But I would like to say, may the love of God be with you continuously and constantly. May it flow in and out of you and express itself in the most beautiful way possible. Let others see you as an example of what love is, what light is, and what positivity can be in its most beautiful form. Let there be continuing helpfulness and prayer and guidance and goodness with you all. And do not let the negativity between you separate you, but let it be a source to find the light together. Find a way to bring yourself into a positive mode so that your light can shine in a greater way. I see so much light out there among you. But yet sometimes it's so hard to know if you're sending out that love to others. It's hard to know how you're being perceived. But let me tell you, the love of God is with you now and will help you to be the fullest person, the greatest giver, the most wonderful of gifts to the earth, because all your gifts within you are meant to shine forth, to give not only you light in this world, but many, many others. Because light in the world can sometimes be lost and sometimes seem dim. You look at other places and there's much going on that seems so dark and negative. But you know, one smile to someone who is lonely can be a changer of the whole day. One piece of food to someone who is hungry can keep them from starving. Be that person that gives that one small thing to that person in need. I love you all, and your gifts will brighten and enlighten the world, and not just one or two people, but this group of people has the ability to brighten the world in a very, very great way. And I give you my blessing to do so. Amen.
Amen. Thank you so much, Yeshua. Namaste. We all love you.
Namaste.
Hello?
Hey. Welcome back, Jim.
Hi.
Hello? Hello?
Oh, now we can hear you.
Yep, they just blocked me. They didn't want me to speak.
Oh.
Sometimes
they do that.
I always wanted to ask a question to Yeshua, and somehow he was coming like several times, and every time I was not able to ask. And this time it was again the same thing. Interesting.
Interesting. That is interesting.
But I was so happy. I was crying and laughing.
All right. Is there a blessing to close today?
I think that Brian has a blessing.
Oh, very good.
I'll do one too, guys. It's Wendy.
Oh, wonderful. Thank you, Wendy.
Wonderful, Wendy.
Yes, can you all hear me okay?
Yep.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Easy on the Okikia. Iliana na kikia, kushukaliana na saleka shiokoto, ilia katanani ya kako sokotua, iliana ni ya kota shala yeni ya kikiokotua, shali inia kia, shala kukuata da yi, kani shala ku, tukuni likia, kukua kakia, shan nia tiki kulua, shani talia kua.
Take everything into your heart, but let only the love be the guide. You see, you must know of all things. You must be prepared for all things. But love is the guide. You must know of the negativity. You must know where things are from. You must have lessons from all different places. But love will be the guide.
Beautiful. Thank you. Next, I think we have Wendy would like to do one.
Good day and good light all and blessings.
Hi, Wendy.
Hi, Jim. Hello, everyone, and a beautiful, beautiful day to you all. And I send your your father love and blessings and healing, and I have been for several days, so I hope he's doing well. Nalita, noyo. Noyo mola asu. Pulkuya shaniana. Haluku sataria shalano. Haluku solu rashaniana. Kamitu. Sonu asha. Sotuku amina. Tila kusila sialura. Sikila sasya la katuriamba kushola sira. Mikia. Ayutu kusala. Sima yala tu. Mima ya walaru. Hakai siela lua sasaya maru. Aki. Alila eliala. Ilina itu. Kila sieta ya nayolora kasarma. Ala sila. Kaya ya yuyushali. Anima lauru. Aki la satya. Kilisia tarima. Ama yawa. Ati kalesoniana, amura hila, titi alaxila, ajlea tialuga, pleatia sana, alia satiga kania, marusha ya isali, isaya, makialati, namaste.
There are lessons for the universe that only the universe can learn, and there are lessons for mankind that only mankind can understand. And there are lessons for each individual that you must take to yourself and learn and grow. All these different kinds of lessons exist for a reason, but they are all one in existence. Because as all things are, they all connect one to another. So the lessons that you learned in the universe will attach to the lessons that you learn as an individual, and will attach to the lessons that many aliens will learn throughout their lives and through their species' lives. There are times when lessons must be learned, and this is a time for great lessons on Earth, great purgings and great negativities to bring out the light, because when it is dark, the light can be seen much brighter.
Thank you, Jim. Namaste.
That is beautiful. Next we have Stephen, who would like to give a blessing.
Excellent.
Thank you. Hello, Max. Thank you. Much love to you all.
Hi. Beautiful. We come from many essences to come together as one. We call on all your essences to be with our one. Our highness is equal to your highness. Our equality blends together in the mesh of love and understanding that is light personified in each of us as individuals. Bring that light to us and let us share with each other those high thoughts that are only those that we can share in this relationship. Realize that we are speaking from many layers and from many levels of good, kind, love, peace, tranquility, but all connected up through with light and love, so that as each individual is separate, we can connect all as one. This depth of tonality speaks to all of us through our hearts and through our same vibration. For all of us will have the same vibration in love. Let it be pure. Let it be motionful, full of motion, and full of light and energy. Well, everybody, I hope that it was a good session today.
Yeah, thank you, Jim.
It was excellent.
Always, Jim. It's always good.
Oh, yes. Thank you. Much love to you all. And Nourishment is calling out to me.
I'm sure you must be a little bit drained. So thank you so much, Jim, for coming and channeling for us today. It was amazing. Well,
thank you all for being with me today. It was really quite beautiful. Your energy was amazing.
Yes. Good. And I just wanted to add in quickly, Wendy, would you like to announce your last event coming up on Monday?
Oh, yeah, tomorrow. Boy, I can't believe it.
The last of our
49-day Bashar's Self-Love Challenge. I'm going to be doing our last hangout together tomorrow afternoon.
No, day after tomorrow.
I'm sorry, on Monday. I'm sorry, I got my days mixed up, guys. I keep thinking it's Sunday. My apologies.
The 29th.
Yes, Monday the 29th. At 1:11 in the afternoon.
I won't be home.
Well, that's okay. Bashar knows everybody's looking to improve their self-love, so.
Bashar was just here the other day, so that was beautiful.
Oh, my gosh, I'm so excited. I can't wait to hang out with you.
Yes, Bashar actually came unexpectedly, and it was a really wonderful treat.
Wow, I'm really excited to see the movie coming out with Daryl and
me too.
Is it called First Contact?
Yes, and if anybody, Daryl Anka, you know the channeler Bashar, is putting together, because he's a filmmaker. For anybody who doesn't know that, that's what he does in his 3D life, and he's got a movie called First Contact, and it's actually his entire story of him and Bashar and channeling, and he's making it look. He's tried to show the world what he sees and what he's experienced, and I'm really excited about
it. And another reason I'm really excited for that movie is because when I was watching the interview with him, he had said that he has scientific proof that the brain goes into what I think it was gamma state when you're channeling. I mean, I'm sure it depends on the type of channeling you're doing, but when Daryl specifically does it, they have, like, you know, they did the testing and everything, so he's super excited to get that out to the public to further show, hey, this is like an actual thing, and actually everybody goes into this state when they're doing what they love to do and everything. So I just wanted to throw that out.
Yeah, his he's actually has an event called Going Gamma. It's actually one of his events. You can purchase it on his website, but yeah, definitely.
I go to the state of Iowa, I think. Just kidding.
Oh, Jim, I miss your corny, cheesy jokes so much.
Altered states, no doubt. Altered states.
Yes. Iowa, the altered state.
Hilarious.
Yes.
Okay.
Announcements about the tomorrow we'll have them. 11 EST, Jim and I will be doing 4-hour webinar on emergency preparedness, how you stock up the toilet paper, and how do you help ascension. And next Reiki 1 class. So people who didn't get into Reiki, that would be an opportunity to you for you to jump in this cycle. So we raised up a group of Reiki. So it was Reiki 1, 2, and 3, I think. So we it was 1 and 2. So we started with a group of Reiki people and did 1 and 2. So already some people kind of graduated into practitioners, and now we're starting the second cycle. So for you, it would be a chance to join that cycle and become a healer.
Anybody that's interested in the energies, even healing energies, channeling energies, Reiki is a good start for getting energies flowing. So not that to say that it's going to open up all your channeling and everything, but that's how it happened for me. I became a channeler through Reiki, so, and I'm a great believer that it does open up many energies in the system.
I agree.
Yeah, basically the idea, yes. I say yes. I say yes. Reiki, channeling, and how do you call it, the third state? Becoming an avatar. Reiki, channeling, and becoming an avatar. There are three necessary factors to help Earth ascension. Basically, you to become plugged in the grid, you have to open up your avatar state, and Reiki and channeling are steps of opening it.
Right. And also, anybody, I wanted to say too, I won't be channeling next week because I have to be with my friend who's having open heart surgery. So perhaps we can discuss who's going to take next week's webinar. Mm-hmm. So we can do that tomorrow if you want.
Okay, dope.
So because the Reiki class, Reiki class is September 18 and Saturday 11 to 3 p and 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. and it's you sign up on humancolony.org. And should we go offline to discuss the channeling next Saturday?
Yeah, we can do that. So I guess we can close here. But thank you, everybody.
Let's do. Unmute yourself and make some noise.
Woohoo! Okay.
Yay!
There you go.
Jim, can you hear me?
Yes, I am hearing you.
Did you get my message?
Where is it?
On Skype and email.
Did I respond to it?
Nope. I just sent it today.
Oh, no, I didn't. You know.